definitely a moving step for me. You know, it's as a rookie coming in, you know, I had a lot of my play at first, you know, just trying to come in and learn the offense. But, you know, Coach Stefanski, Coach Perriani did an amazing job, you know, just getting me ready. And, you know, each week I just try to come, you know, with the mindset that, you know, I can't be stopped and this offense can't be stopped. So, you know, I just try to have that mindset each day. And, you know, each game is more experience for me under my belt.
Hey, Irv, when you get into the bye week this late in the season, it's almost like having played an entire college football season before you head into a bowl game. How do you feel physically at this point compared to where you would in a typical college season?
I feel amazing, honestly. I've really been, you know, trying to take care of my body as much as I can. You know, I do Pilates twice a week, acupuncture massage twice a week. And, you know, I feel like college is a little more demanding on your body. Obviously, the NFL is, you know, top-notch. But I feel like Alabama definitely prepared me for this, you know, moving forward to the NFL. You know, obviously, Alabama isn't the NFL, but I feel like it's the closest thing to it. And, you know, Coach Saban did an awesome job of preparing us. And, you know, it's awesome having that under my belt. But, you know, just moving forward, just trying to stay healthy and do what I can.
Hey, Steven. This is Andrew Kramer from the Star Tribune. I think one of the players, I can't remember who afterward, just talked about, though, the interior pass rush was a big focus maybe towards the second half of that game against the Broncos, trying to stop some of those deep passes. How do you feel you guys did just in terms of getting that interior pass rush going?
I thought we were able to apply pressure and get him off of a spot, making him less accurate down the field. So it was about getting to his feet and getting him uncomfortable.
Courtney Cronin from ESPN.com. How has, with Linville being out for a few weeks, how has the interior pass rush had to, I guess, maybe change a little bit just in lieu of his with his absence?
If someone like that goes down, you have to do everything you can to make up for the production on the inside. So, I mean, it's up to us to step it up each and every week and learn how to play with each other and the new dynamic and the new schemes we have each week versus each opponent.
And this just being your fourth year, and then obviously you got to get more playing time with Everson's situation last year, but how do you feel how this year's gone for you, and is it the role that you've expected?
I'm happy whenever I get opportunity to step on the field and show what I got to help the team work towards a win. So, yeah, I'm happy to get out there. I feel like I've been making the most of it. There are definitely some times where I could have got the quarterback down or done a little bit better with some pass rushes, but that's life. That's the game.
Sam Ekstrom with zone coverage. You know, after the disappointment of the Kansas City game, for the defense to be on the field at the end and get two stops to win the last two games, how big is that for that unit?
When it comes down to it, the offense put us in a position to put the game on us, and we were able to answer the call back-to-back times after coming off of that that loss in Kansas City. So we were able to prove ourselves back-to-back weeks.
Ben Gessling with the Star Tribune. As you head into the bye week now, and I think you get a little more time off than usual, even with you guys being able to get out of here a couple days early, what is the biggest key to having a bye week this late and still being able to take advantage of it when you've had 11 weeks already of aches and pains from the season?
You just said there's a lot of people with bumps and bruises, aches and pains. It gives them opportunity to feel better, get their legs back underneath them, step away from football, reset your mindset, and then attack these last five games of the regular season with all you got to prepare yourself for the playoffs.
Is there a time of year that you found that you prefer to have the bye? I mean, it seems like you've kind of had everything from early in the season to this. Is there a time that it comes better than others?
Of course, you don't want like a week two bye or anything like that. That would be horrible. But I feel like on the back end, at least after eight games, past the halfway point, any of those are good times. So I feel like our bye week came at a great time for us, especially.